This episode is brought to you by domain.com.
Do girls who go together really flow together? Hey guys, Amy with you on DNews today, talking about one of the more common lady myths, menstrual synchrony, or the idea that women who spend a lot of time together find themselves menstruating at the same time. Since the 1970s, there have been a few studies to suggest that synchronized menstruation is possible between roommates, lesbian couples, and sexually segregated groups of women. But there have also been studies to suggest that synchrony isn't a real thing. Roommates who are not close friends and lesbian couples living together for a number of years have been found to not sync their cycles. Some studies have split the difference to find that women's cycles adjust for closer flow dates, but only by a day or two. But more recent research says that synchrony isn't really a thing. Two separate studies done in 2006 found that menstrual synchrony is actually just chance. It's normal for a woman's cycle to last anywhere from 21 to 35 days, with menses lasting between 5 and 7 days. And variations in that cycle are pretty common. Many women experience erratic or even missed periods. So not only are regular periods actually quite irregular, there are all kinds of things that can impact your cycle. Stress is a common culprit, be it personal stress like a breakup, professional like losing your job, or life stress like moving to a new city. Scientists aren't exactly sure how this one works, but we do know that stress affects the hypothalamus gland that controls the pituitary gland that in turn controls the ovaries, among other things, and helps manage hormones. And hormone imbalance can lead to a change in cycle. We see this most commonly with medication. Antidepressants and antipsychotics can elevate the pituitary hormone called prolactin that can affect the hormones responsible for regulating your cycle. Hormonal birth control also affects a woman's cycle by preventing ovulation and thickening cervical mucus to prevent pregnancy. But even non-hormonal birth control like copper IUDs can disrupt a cycle just by virtue of putting a foreign object inside the uterus. Changes in diet and exercise can affect your cycle as well. Working out typically leads to shorter, lighter periods, but excessive exercise can actually stop menstruation altogether. It has to do with body fat. Too little body fat and a woman stops ovulating. On the opposite end of the spectrum, weight gain can cause the ovaries to produce extra testosterone, leading to longer cycles or missed periods. Illness, though more serious illnesses than a common cold, can also affect a cycle. It's not unheard of for a woman to bleed while seriously ill with a virus, changing her cycle's start date. But like all myths, there's a grain of truth in the idea that women can sync by proximity. Pheromones are the chemical substances we excrete through sweat that give other people subtle messages about us. One of these pheromones secreted in armpit sweat is called 5-alpha-androstenol and is thought to be linked to menstrual synchrony. So while it's possible that smelling 5-alpha-androstenol affects women's cycles leading them to sync, it's far more likely that all the other things that are known to affect a woman's period are actually what causes the appearance of synchrony. Because when you think about it, two women menstruating for around 5 days a month would probably end up overlapping at some point. So, ladies, have you ever found yourself seemingly syncing up with a roommate or close friend? Let us know in the comments below, or you can find me and let me know directly on Twitter as AST Vintage Space. And don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.